From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. The FBI has asked for court permission to search a computer belonging to the boyfriend of the Scarborough woman whose body was discovered along with three others near a beach on Long Island. An agent has filed an application seeking access to a laptop belonging to Akeem Cruz. Cruz is one of the last people to have seen 22-year-old Waterman the weekend she disappeared after traveling to a hotel. Authorities say while in New York, Waterman worked as an escort advertising herself on Craigslist. Court papers reveal agents were seeking evidence of sex trafficking. Cruz is currently jailed here in Maine on an unrelated drug charge. A sudden drop in temperature turned wet roads into icy roads, causing more than two dozen crashes in 2 hours. The York County Sheriff's Department says they responded to about 25 crashes this morning. They say many of them were rollovers and several people were taken to the hospital. The accidents happened in South Berwick, Lebanon, Alfred, Lyman, and Waterboro. Rain that fell earlier this morning froze on the roads when the temperature dropped. A nice reminder that boating season is just around the corner. The first of four area boat shows kicked off today at Portland's Sports Complex. Enthusiasts had the chance to learn more about the latest equipment and products. Visitors could also attend free clinics and seminars and check out the newest models before they even hit the water. Organizers say it was a busy day, and that means good things for the economy.
Today has been a definite indicator to me that things are improving. But we do have boats that are $10,000-$15,000 all the way up, you know, so all families probably can get into a boat.
The boat show also featured a radio-controlled sailboat regatta pool and a chowder cook-off. In Agunkwit today, Southern Spirit warmed Main Street. The town's annual Mardi Gras celebration, led by the King and Queen, continued with the hat and mask parade, a steel drum band, and ice sculptures. There was also a mask-making party and music. People who attended today's parade say the celebration is a reminder of the upcoming spring season.
And it's grown from then, and everybody thinks Mardi Gras at Agunkwit in the winter. Who comes to Agunkwit? Everybody. And I go with the premise that not everybody skis, and those of you that aren't on the mountain, you're welcome here.
The three-day celebration also featured ice skating at the community rink, and this is the fourth year of Agunkwit's Mardi Gras celebration. Thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.